TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I am Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 6th of December. All four accused in Wetts rape and murder case killed in encounter in India. Political solution needed in Afghanistan, says NATO. And Sajith Premadasa named Sri Lanka's opposition leader. And now for all the details. All four accused who were allegedly involved in the gang rape and murder of a veterinary doctor in India's southern Hyderabad city were gunned down by police in an encounter in the wee hours of Friday. The killing of the accused has drawn applause from the victim's family and citizens who were outraged over crimes against women.
All four accused in the rape and murder case of a 27-year-old veterinarian in India's southern Hyderabad city were killed in an exchange of fire with police on Friday. The incident took place early Friday morning when the accused were taken to the site of the offence for reconstruction of the scene of the crime as part of the investigation, police said. Two policemen were also injured during the firing. The four men, all lorry workers aged between 20 and 24, were arrested on November 29 for raping and killing the woman and later burning her body. They were remanded to 7 days judicial custody.
They snatched away weapons from our two officers and started firing. So even though our officers maintained restraint and asked them to surrender, but without listening to us, they continued to fire and continued to attack us. So again, our people started in retaliation. In that retaliation, the four accused got killed.
The killings of the accused has drawn applause from the victim's family and citizens who were outraged over crimes against women.
मैं उसको लिए गवर्नमेंट तेलंगाना सरकार और पुलिस और मैं जो मेरे साथ लोगों को सबको बताई दे देता हूँ मैं
The gang rape and murder triggered a nationwide outrage with the public and lawmakers demanding speedy punishment to the perpetrators. Government of Telangana province had ordered setting up a special court to expedite the trial. Meanwhile, India's Interior Ministry has sought a report from the Telangana government on the encounter.
The Philippines-based Asian Development Bank on Friday approved an emergency loan of $1 billion to cash-strapped Pakistan. The Pakistan government had asked the bank for the loan in September to build the country's foreign exchange reserves.
The Asian Development Bank or ADB has approved an emergency loan of $1 billion for Pakistan to help strengthen the country's slumping economy. In a press release issued on Friday, the Philippine-based bank said the emergency loan is part of a multi-donor economic reform program spearheaded by the International Monetary Fund, or IMF, to stabilize Pakistan's economy, which crumbled in mid-2018. Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government in Pakistan had asked ADB for the loan in September to build the country's foreign exchange reserves. The loan was approved after the government implemented a series of IMF-supported reforms and actions to improve its current account deficit, strengthen its revenue base, and protect the poor against the social impact of the economic crisis. In July, the IMF approved a three-year, $6 billion extended fund facility to finance the government's economic reform program that aims to put Pakistan's economy on the path of sustainable and inclusive growth.
Moving on, residents in Pakistan-administered Kashmir are irked by the rising inflation in the region as prices of consumer goods, including food, has reached all-time high. Inflation has skyrocketed in recent months because of massive debts, rampant corruption and inefficient policies by Pakistani establishment that has illegally occupied the region.
Residents in Pakistan administered Kashmir are irked by the rising inflation in the region, as prices of consumer goods, including food and clothing, have reached an all-time high. Locals complain that in recent weeks, the price of vegetables, especially tomatoes, has surged between 300 to 400 rupees per kg, triggering anger among them. As winter has set in, buying warm clothes to protect themselves from the chilly season has also become out of reach due to soaring prices.
महंगाई सिर्फ टमाटर नहीं, सब्जियां सारी की सारी महंगी हैं, हर चीज़ यहाँ पर बहुत ज़्यादा, गरीब आदमी का जो गुजर औकात है वो बहुत मुश्किल हो जा रही है, खासकर जो हमारा मुलाजम तबका है उसकी तो बिल्कुल ही मतलब कमर टूट गई है, और फिर उसके अलावा मजदूर हैं, दिहाड़ीदार हैं, हर चीज़ बहुत ज़्यादा महंगी हो चुकी है।
तो हम मछली 300-250 रुपये बेचते हैं, लोग तंग करते हैं महंगाई की वजह से, सब लोग तंग आए हुआ है, तो सर्दी भी है, लोग मछली भी खाती है और महंगाई भी बहुत है, तो मसला मसाइल ये चाहिए महंगाई, हम दरख्वास्त करते हैं चाहिए महंगाई ख़त्म हो जाए, क्योंकि हम गरीबों लोगों के लिए बहुत सख्ती है, बहुत ज़्यादा परेशानी है।
Inflation in Pakistan has skyrocketed in recent months because of massive debts, rampant corruption and inefficient policies by Pakistani establishment that has illegally occupied the region.
NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg has said that a political negotiated solution is needed in Afghanistan. While reaffirming the NATO's support to Afghan security forces, he welcomed ongoing efforts to restart peace talks with the Taliban.
NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg has said that he believes that the political negotiated solution was needed in Afghanistan, while reaffirming the bloc's support for Afghan security forces with training, assist and advising. Addressing a presser in London this week, Stoltenberg said NATO will continue to be in Afghanistan and it hopes that the peace process will provide a credible peace deal. The NATO Secretary General also welcomed recent efforts to restart the peace talks with the Taliban.
We are committed to continue to support Afghanistan because we strongly believe that the best way NATO can support the peace efforts is to train, assist and advise the Afghan security forces so Taliban understand that they will never win on the battlefield. They have to sit down and make real and serious compromises on the negotiating table.
This comes as U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad met top Afghan leadership in Kabul on Wednesday to exchange views related to the peace process. According to a statement from the U.S. State Department, Khalilzad will rejoin the talks with the Taliban in Doha to discuss steps for a peaceful settlement to the ongoing conflict in the country.
Afghans across the country have been shocked at the killing of Japanese doctor Tetsu Nakamura, who was fatally shot along with five others in a roadside attack in eastern Afghanistan this week. Nakamura was recently granted honorary Afghan citizenship for his humanitarian engagements.
The killing of renowned Japanese doctor and aid worker Tetsu Nakamura in a gun attack in eastern Afghanistan has sparked outrage and shock across the country. Mourners gathered in capital Kabul for a candlelight vigil on Thursday to remember him and five other Afghans who were shot dead by unknown gunmen in a roadside attack on Wednesday in eastern Afghanistan. The mourners paid tributes to Nakamura's humanitarian engagements in Afghanistan. Head of Peace Japan Medical Services, the Japanese doctor was prominently known for construction of wells and irrigation in villages where many suffered from cholera and other diseases because of a lack of clean water.
Afghan will never forget his services for this country. He was a brave Afghan, he was a brave Japanese, he was a brave doctor. He served Afghan nation, not only Nangarhar, but the whole Afghanistan. In Afghanistan, Afghan nation will love him and will keep him in their memories.
Nakamura had recently been granted honorary Afghan citizenship for decades of humanitarian work in the east of the country. While investigations are still underway to nab those behind the attack, the Taliban has denied responsibility.
In news from Sri Lanka, United National Party Deputy Leader Sajit Premadasa has been named the leader of opposition by the party's parliamentary group in a meeting on Thursday. Premadasa will officially be appointed when the parliament convenes on January 3 next year.
United National Party Deputy Leader Sajid Premadasa was on Thursday named the leader of opposition weeks after he lost the presidential contest to Gotabaya Rajapaksa in the presidential poll. The party's parliamentary group held a meeting on Thursday, following which party leader and former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe agreed to nominate Premadasa in his place. This comes after the United National Party resolved internal differences, with some in the party backing Wickremesinghe for the post. Wickremesinghe will, however, continue to lead the party. Premadasa will be officially appointed as leader of opposition when the parliament convenes in January. President Gotabaya Rajapaksa recently prorogued the house for a month until January 3 next year. Opposition parties said the move was aimed at keeping out parliamentary opposition to his minority government until then.
Locals, including women in Udhampur district of India's Jammu and Kashmir, are engaging in mushroom cultivation as a means to increase their income. They have been making good profits with the help of local agriculture authorities who are training them for the business.
A growing number of people, including women, are engaging in mushroom cultivation in Udhampur district of India's Jammu and Kashmir as a means to increase their income. With mushroom being considered as an easy cash crop, over 100 women from the region are right now engaged in its cultivation. An agriculture department official said locals are actively participating in the process and are learning the techniques of the cultivation.
पिछले साल तक हम 200 लोग पूरी तरह से ट्रेंड कर चुके थे लेकिन इस बार अभी 250 लोग अभी इसमें पूरी तरह से जिनको ट्रेनिंग दी गई है और जो रेगुलरली ये एक्टिविटी अभी फॉलो कर रहे हैं हमने अभी देखा कि इसमें वुमेन खास तौर से कम से कम 100 वुमेन भी इसके बीच में काम कर रही हैं
बाकी भी सब लोगों को करना चाहिए जिनकी आमदनी नहीं है खासकर कि लेडीज के लिए काम बहुत अच्छा है जैसे कि घर का काम भी कर सकती हैं अपने परिवार को भी देख सकती हैं सारा कुछ घर को मैनेज करके ये मशरूम का घर बैठे काम है ये बाहर जाने की जरूरत नहीं है तो इसमें आमदनी भी अच्छी है आपकी लागत कम पड़ेगी और आमदनी आपको अच्छी मिल सकती है
Encouraging people towards such initiatives are part of government schemes that had been launched to reduce poverty among farmers and the weaker sections of the society.
Daunted by the continuously diminishing air quality in major Indian cities, residents in Western Rajkot city have come up with a solution on their own to fight pollution. They have created an oxygen park by planting over 150 varieties of trees to provide clean air.
People of India's Western Rajkot city have come up with a solution on their own to fight pollution. Daunted by the continuously diminishing air quality in major cities. Residents of Rajkot have created an oxygen park by planting over 150 varieties of trees to provide clean air. The residents began work on the oxygen park 15 months ago and now it has taken the shape of a mini forest in the area. This well-researched park includes hundreds of trees which are rich in terms of oxygen emission and carbon dioxide absorption.
In spite of living of this concrete jungle, we are suffering from many diseases. To make our health better and to live a healthy life, we need to make such oxygen parks in each and every city.
Ekdam peaceful, ekdam relaxation jagah hai. You can also feel the deep oxygen over here. So yahan ka jo pura atmosphere hai, wo itna adbhut develop kiya hai ke jo aushadhi wale, jo natural, jo forest guard ke jo trees hai, wo sab ko mila ke yahan ki ye jagah ko ये पूरे अर्बन जो कंक्रीट का एरिया है नजदीक में उसके बीच में भी ऐसा ऑक्सीजन वन हो सकता है
The concept has worked well and received a lot of appreciation for efforts in doing a bit to save the environment from the looming climate crisis. India is home to the world's 14 most polluted cities according to the World Health Organization. Toxic air claimed 1.24 million lives here in 2017. A study in Lancet Planetary Health showed.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/fasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.